Surface Treatment Workshop is the title of a book written by Darlene Olivia McElroy and Sandra Duran Wilson. It was released in May 2011, and I was fascinated the moment it arrived at our warehouse. Today we're going to experiment with some of the mixed media techniques in the book. We'll be using gels, mediums, and other products, products you may have wondered how to utilize in your own art. We'll answer some of those questions today as we set off on our surface treatment journey. The first products we're going to use today are light and coarse molding pastes. I'm using Golden products. You can use whichever brand you prefer. I just happen to have these around. Now, this is something that I started yesterday, and what I've done is taken some light modeling paste, and I've used a circle template, and I've just pushed the modeling paste, used the template like a stencil, and I also just smeared some modeling paste on here, and there'll be a still photo of this after the fact that I want to show you. What we're going to do now is use this same circle template, and just I'm going to show you how you go ahead and get the paste through the template. And it's really as simple as this. You just hold that in place, and then you smear the paste into the circles. Now you can smooth these out if you want to make them really smooth, or you can do what I've done, which is to leave them a little bit textured on the top. All right, I did those first few with light modeling paste. I'm going to mix some coarse in to this one, and then I'm going to fill the last two with these. And then the next step that we're going to do is we're going to put some acrylic glazes made with acrylic glaze, glazing medium, and paint over the top of these, and you'll see how interesting they look afterward. This is 140-pound watercolor paper that I made some circles. This is light molding paste here and the coarse back here. Another of the techniques that Sandra and Darlene talk about in the book are using glazes over all of these kinds of materials. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix some fluid acrylic paint with some acrylic glazing medium, and I'm going to wash it over the top to see what it looks like. Mix this up. All right, I'm going to start with a slightly dampened brush, but not wet, and see how this works. And I'm just going to pull some color into the brush. And wash it over this and see how it works. Now the interesting thing here is that you can see this where the molding paste is not smooth. Some of the color has caught in the grooves and in the peaks on the molding paste. This is the light molding paste. Now I'm going to do the same thing over the coarse molding paste, and we'll see how that looks. This actually grabs the paint quite a bit differently. You can definitely see that there's more texture in here, and you can see where the paint again accumulates, and it makes some interesting texture on there. This is glass bead gel, also by Golden, that again, I did this on this piece of paper. I have bead gel and I have fiber paste, and I'm going to try the same thing. I have the same wash of cobalt turquoise paint, and I'm just going to brush this over here. And interestingly enough, the glass beads will not pick up any of the paint themselves, but you can certainly see the texture as the paint falls down in among the beads. Let me do the same thing now with the fiber paste. What each of these products does is give you options to create various kinds of techniques on your piece, whether it's an art journal page or a larger mixed media piece that you're working on. And the fiber paste actually is very interesting. The this is coarse modeling paste, and you can see that here I applied it just to the watercolor paper directly from the bottle, and here I loosely mixed some cobalt turquoise in it. The nice thing about all of these products is that you can mix color into the paste before you apply it to your substrate. And then, of course, you can come back after the fact and add more color, which I obviously showed you a few moments ago, but I'm going to just use some purple here and show you how it looks off against the white, and then once I brush it over here, you're going to get some real interesting colors. So again, I've made a glaze by mixing my paint with some acrylic glazing medium, and I'm mixing in just a little bit of water so that it will move for me, and I'm going to just brush it on here. And again, this is a really cool effect. I like the way it gathers in the peaks and the valleys, but I think it's going to be even more interesting once I drag this across the modeling paste that's had the cobalt turquoise mixed in, because now what I'm getting is a whole different look. And I like this a lot. I think this is very interesting. And obviously then the other option would be if I had washed some color onto the watercolor paper first, then mixed the cobalt turquoise with the modeling paste and put it on, and then added a glaze over the top once it was dry, we get lots of different colors and lots of different layers. This next technique utilizes Golden's clear tar gel. What I did in preparation was I took this piece of 140-pound watercolor paper and I dipped the palette knife into the tar gel and just let it drizzle out. It creates very fine strings, and this works as a resist. What I've done is I have the tar gel on this white piece of paper. I'm going to come in now with some paint and I'm going to wash it over the tar gel, and you'll see that what happens is we're not going to get paint wherever that tar gel is. Now once this dries, I will come back and I'm going to remove the paint that sits on top of the strings so that you'll really see the patterning, and there'll be a still photo of this also. This is the same product, Golden's Tar Gel, and what I've done is mixed a little bit of cobalt turquoise in here, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to let it string on this piece that I started last night. And all you have to do is just let this slowly fall off of the knife and make those strings. Now in this case, it's not only going to act as a resist, it's also going to act as a color layer, because there's obviously color in the string gel. And I can come back and I can grab some more. This technique uses rubbing alcohol to create patterns in wet paint. The first step is to paint your substrate and let that first layer dry. After it is dry, you're going to come in, and I have some red paint. It's a little bit diluted, it's not straight out of the bottle, and I'm going to brush this on, and then I'm going to drizzle alcohol on it, and you'll see the patterns that form. I just have rubbing alcohol in an eyedropper, and now I'm going to just drop the alcohol on here, and you see the rings that form. Now I'm betting if I did this, that would work too, and sure enough it does. So you can almost use the eyedropper like a pen and form patterns that way also. This technique is going to use salt as a resist, but before I put the salt on, what I'm going to do, and this is something that I like to do, is I've taken this piece of watercolor paper and I've pre-wet it. I want to create a wash of acrylic paint on here, much like you would wash watercolor on. So you want to make certain that your paper is good and wet, and even if you have a little bit of puddling on there, that's okay, because it's going to make the paint move and it creates some interesting effects. So once that paper is wet, I'm just going to take regular acrylic paint that I'm going to mix some water into, and I'm going to swirl it on here to get the color moving. And you can see the water bleeding out here. Now I'm just going to take some coarse kosher salt, and wherever this salt lands, it's going to push the paint away and will probably cause some starburst effects on here too. And I'll take a still photo of this so that you can see it after the fact.